book about, well, several elements. It's, at its root, it's a story about Matt Lawson, who loses his brother and father in a snowstorm. And in the West, you don't have a lot of set of instructions for how to grow up anyway. And the book is really basically about him trying to find a way to be a good man in the face of a lot of violence, a lot of poverty, and just the natural forces in the place he lives. I chose it because I was given an assignment when I was in graduate school to write a story that takes place in the same place but at three different time periods. And the place that I chose to write about was a place I was very familiar with, and also it was a place that was drowned by Grand Coulee Dam. So it was a natural for a place that has changed quite a bit. And so that was sort of the nucleus for the book, and the time period had to do with when the dam was built. I chose the beginning of the 20th century because if I was going to write about a person's life, I needed about 75 years. If he was going to be at the correct age when the dam was being built, I had to start around 1918 and I had to end around 1978 so that the dam story would fit in the middle. I am interested in that time period because it's the West had ceased being what everybody thinks of when they think of Westerns. It was beginning to move toward modern life, but it hadn't quite gotten there yet. And so it was a chance for me to write about, I think, a time period that doesn't get touched much when people think of where I live and where I come from. Yes, this book was a book that was difficult for me to write. I've been working on it for a long time, and it covers a large time period. And my wife kept at it. It's kept me at it. It was a place where I was. It's the place where her father was born. Some of my friends didn't think it was a very good book, and it probably wasn't at certain times. But she saw something in it and kept me moving. It's the closest thing I'll write to a love story, and it's hers.